The samples we use must be fresh. Let's use what you've gathered before they spoil.
I am no beast of burden.
Welcome. Farewell.
Mervale dwells in the caves beyond the wrecks, at the head of Siren's Cove. Leave her be, and we can only hope that she continues to return the favor. While we live, we are blessed.
Tala, Exile.
Welcome. Farewell.
Thank you.
Welcome. Stay sharp out there.
Hello. Farewell. Welcome, husband. We knew in our hearts that you would find us. Come, Doresso. Ambrosia and Amarissa must meet their father. Come, my love. Return to your family.
suck it up, she'll fall.
Ah!
I am no beast of burden.
If you must take your chances with the siren, then have this. It may be of some help. But please, know that you don't have to do this. Tarkley and I are getting used to having you around. Farewell.
Thank you. Welcome.
Stay sharp out there.
This is love's true face. Your flesh is ours! Your flesh is ours!
Corrupted beyond humanity. I must cure this plague before it sickens all of God's creation.
Doresso gave me the gem, kissed me, promised that he would be by my side forever. I sang for him. I sang for Oriath with his gem at my throat. Kalisa's gem. Kalisa's voice. I sang in her echo, performing arias that had once made the Empire weep. I listened to Kalisa's lullabies in my dreams. I gave myself to her music, mind and body. Doresso left me for Sarn with a promise to free me from Kalisa. I begged him not to go, tried to show him the wonder of my transformation, the beautiful daughters he would soon meet. He couldn't see. None of them could see. I fled from their hatred. When Doresso returns, I will cast his cure away. I will teach him what true love is.
This forest, so twisted. I pray that I'm not too late to turn the tide of this corruption.
Quite the lady killer, aren't you? That singing squid didn't stand a chance.
Knew it from the first time I saw those sharp peepers of yours. My pirates notwithstanding, I thank you on behalf of all the fallen brethren of the waves. Now that the final cadence has been played, no one need remember Mervale's song.
I thought you're a fool for seeking out Mervale. A fool in love with death. Now, I don't know. Still, you've delivered this coast from the terrors that long held sway here. We may now find some respite, and that's more than any of us could have hoped for. But please, consider this. What have you become when even nightmares fear you? Take care.
Damn me. I didn't think it possible. All these souls Mervale and her brood have consumed over the years. You've done right by those that are dead, and by those who still might live. Farewell.
Calm stands before us and looks out to the raging sea. He sings, calls, screams to our ancestors to come to our aid. He offers them gifts of old, a feast of heart and mind, muscle and marrow, cooked in the fire and rock of this angry land.
My Allflame, my blessed, damned Allflame. Oh, you want your moment in the firelight now, do you? Unfortunately, necessity is what it is, and for the Allflame to give life, it must first be kindled with life. And since suitable kindling is in short supply around these parts, I have little option but to make do with what I have. Namely, you.
Temptation may turn even the noblest of men. I should take heed.
Consider using those samples before you journey onwards, Exile.
Calm is gone. Our king has taken our finest 500 warriors and descended into the depths of Rayclast. He spoke to us of a vision, a gift from the ancestors. Calm has been deceived. The vision was a gift from the Black Spirit. It has conquered Calm. The Black Spirit has conquered the Karui way. Hairi has made ready her canoes. We will take those that are left, 500 forgotten families, and carry them back to their true homes. Back to Nga Makanui. Khan's promises have led us into nightmare. Hairi will lead us back to the dawn.
Fairgraves was a good man, a fine explorer. He opened the door to many a new world, for better or for worse, usually for worse when it came to the natives. There's some peace in the knowledge that he now rests where he should. Let's not speak of Fairgraves again, shall we? He was an inspiration to many. It would be a shame to spoil a good hero.
Hello. Be well.
Thank you. I am Grust. I hunt boar, hunt to feed my people. You are not a friend to us. You'll need to run faster than boar. Travel f-
I have seen many an exile come and go, into the forest or into the ground. You seem different somehow. Different good, different bad, it's hard to tell at this stage. The name is Eremir, and for now you have the benefit of my doubt. Those bandits you've encountered out there, they're the dregs of Oriath. And with any foul broth, the nastiest chunks bubble to the surface. The lords of Larceny, Oak, Creighton, and Alira, the self-appointed monarchs of the forest, Creighton in the east, Alira in the west, Oak in the north, and this village, this tribe, we pay their taxes. I would never venture to say that life in Rayclast is easy, but with those three gone, well, living here might just become possible. Keep your wits about you.
You and me, we are the same. We dream big. We find new places. We do not tell stories. Stories are told about us. I learn the words, the ways of Oriath. You listen to me, and not pigheads like Grust. Then you will live to find more new places.
I am Yina, keeper of the spirit. Are you a kind exile like Eremir? He is good to us, helps us. You will stay and help us too, yes? A beast hunts us in her dreams, a great white beast, tortured and maddened by bad men, a long time gone. She will come here one night to tear, crush, and eat. Her pain tells her to. Find the white beast and end her pain before she shares it with us. Stay true to you.
Thank you.
What? Return, if you must. Troubles you bring now. Return if you must.
And so your path leads you here, Exile. Be careful where you step. For as one foot leads the other, so too does each foot leave its mark. A trace of what was, a guide to what will be. I will see you again.